I'm the ambassador of Denmark to India. My name is Freddy Svane. I have one brand in India, which is Freddy is Ready for Business. And I've been interacting with a lot of people all over India. You can just not sit behind your desk in an office in Delhi. You have to interact with people, and thereby realizing that this country is huge. I mean, it's like Europe, but still we consider this a country. But going from north, where you are really hitting the, you're standing on the Himalayas, down to the south, which is so different. And if I had to take a plane from Delhi to the south, it takes me almost 3 hours. It's like going from Copenhagen to Madrid or Lisbon. So it's not just kind of one country, it's really different cultures. And I often like this picture or image of India being kind of multi-layered puzzle. You have so many layers, you have so many puzzles, and it shows that India is really fantastic. Why I'm here? I love India. I want really to make a difference in the sense that I see a lot of opportunities here. It's not just about profits, contracts, orders, and all that, but merely to secure that this very old culture or these very old cultures can be interlinked with Danish culture. I think we have a lot to offer. And I go to many, many places in India, and I see many similarities, but also very big differences. But it's all creating a colorful, incredible India. And I'm sure that coming to India, living in India, your eyes and your mind will be changed. I know we'll put it in the following way, that there's a time before India and after India. And when you are in India, you experience a lot of things, and the changes are perhaps not as polished and following a clear-cut line that we'll find in other countries, but they're changing in their own ways, and that's really fantastic. To see this country building up a infrastructure, not only in roads and bridges, but more importantly, cultural infrastructure, where they're combining old cultural traditions, taking them into the future, being proud of what they came from, and securing that they are also really being based on the past. I mean, it's so interesting to see how past can be really interlinked, mixed up with the future, and that gives a lot of hope. Our culture, the European culture, I mean, to some extent, perhaps we have hit a kind of ceiling, because what is next? In India, nobody will ask what is next, because a lot of things will develop over the years, have been developing over the years, and I see great opportunities. So that's the mind kind of blowing fact of India. I've seen huge rockets being launched. I've seen people really trying to survive in what we call off-grid India. India, where there's no connectivity, no power, no schools, no roads, no whatever. And still they are developing new kind of ways of living, new ways of solving this and that daily life oriented problem. And they're so good at it. And that's, I mean, when I'm looking into what can India give me as a person, I think it tells me that you might live for a number of generations, but to have a country and a culture that will change the world, that is really something. And India has been changing the world, and I'm sure in the future you will see India playing a very big role in changing the kind of the global culture. And there will be no kind of global culture without a very strong Indian presence. So that's so mind-boggling and mind-blowing in the sense that, I mean, you can meet people who have really, they have nothing. But as soon as they have been given something, they can move from nothing to something. And that's what India is about. And India is really offering a lot of opportunities to people, and it gives a kind of satisfaction to see how people are really fighting to get at a better living standard, but they're doing it also in respect of their culture. I've never been to a country where the spiritualism and religions are playing such a huge role, and they walk hand in hand. Whereas in our culture, perhaps religion is not, I mean, well, it's old-fashioned, and now we're closing down churches and all that because we can't afford it. Here you see temples all over the place. People were taking kind of personal interest in being in line with the gurus and believing that there are more in between the skies and the planet and so forth. That's fantastic. So if you want really to really develop yourself as a human being, India is definitely part of that. And so I'm happy to live in India. I hope to live here for a number of years. And the more years you will stay here, the more you will take with you when you are leaving. But I'm sure that passing through the Indian kind of challenge, you will be a far better human being, and you'll have an understanding that the world is not just how it's being decided in boardrooms and so forth. The individual is playing a role. And I think we should reach back to some of these basic things that we see happening in India. That will make us better human beings. And perhaps it will also add to our ability to solve some of these global issues that we are all being confronted with. And I met so many people who are not just asking what's in it for me, but trying really to secure that the community can survive. And that's fantastic. And one other thing which has really changed my kind of perception is the very strong family bonds that you find here in India. Whereas in our culture, we have given up the families. I mean, family, what is that? Something old-fashioned that perhaps we were taught about in the schools. In India, it's very much alive, and you see people who are so so proud of living in kind of big family houses where the two or three generations are living under the same roof, still having their own private life, of course, but they are also caring about each other. Perhaps as a recipe for a more sustainable, also in a human being kind of approach, a more sustainable development and sustainable future by looking into how India is growing, but also how they are growing and how they are maintaining some of the basic basics that are so important to develop life and secure that we also have a future. The planet is not a given thing. One day it might really disappear, and where to go? So the answer lies with us, within us, and in our interaction with other populations and nations and people. So these bonds of people to people, individuals to individuals, so important. And Indians are very good at that. So I'm sure that India is really changing the minds of people. And the more people that will come to India will definitely get something that they can rely on, and perhaps they can mature as human beings. And that is so important, that we're all getting better and getting more understandable as to what is happening and what is not happening. So India is definitely a place to go. If you want really to mature as a human being, touch India and get really prepared for the future. And you can be prepared for the future. So Freddie is ready for India.